As an interior designer, working remotely has posed a couple of challenges, but I think it's definitely offered a lot of exciting opportunities as well.
Short of making actual physical models and mock-ups and so on, we can do pretty much everything else with tools that we usually use. The most important tool is thinking through structure of how we work together. Once we get that right, then you can really use very basic, very simple things such as PDFs, markups. We do a lot of hand sketching, basic communication, the way architects communicate with each other. The other thing that's interesting is hand sketching, ability to sketch things very quickly. I think a lot of remote work is how do you move fast and about clarity of intent. You have to express your intent, your ideas in the simplest way possible.
Presenting materials to clients has evolved a little bit during the work from home strategy. We do a lot of digital lookbooks to get client buy-in, and we utilize material trays where we order samples to our home and assemble them together and then photograph them and use them during meetings as an aid to kind of help supplement the experience of the client actually being able to see and touch the materials in person. So it's a lot of digital lookbooks, a lot of 3D renderings, vignettes, just to get a sense of textures and materiality and how they work together. And then also just camera face-to-face communication.
In the pre-COVID, a lot of interaction with a client was really very much built around these scheduled workshops that involved a lot of travel and logistics and so on. Remote work allows for more spontaneous exchanges with a client, which is quite good. People are more eager to sort of get on phone calls, pull up a screen, sketch together. And in a way, it can really be effective because, again, the client is kind of brought into the flow of the design process. And, you know, depending on the relationships, you could do it on a daily basis.
For us, that has meant more frequent meetings and then also doing digital social happy hours with the whole project team so that we have that level of community and we know that we're all in this process together, even though it's a little different and challenging because of COVID. We extend that to our clients as well.
And we as a firm, you know, we're not bounded by physical boundaries of each individual office. We really bring the very best people in profession, regardless of where they live.
This is a very collaborative profession, but I think the things that we were afraid of, now we've proven that it can happen. We can still meet our schedules. We can still collaborate. We just find different ways to do it. And I feel like a lot of the lessons that we learn will certainly carry over until the time when we can work from the office.